Is anyone excited about returning to school? All right, go ahead, tell me, what's going on?
Well, going back to school is not only like our social life, we have been cut out of our social life since, what, March?
Right.
It's been March since we've been able to like actually socialize with everybody, and for a lot of students, school is like the only social life that we get.
Sure.
And then I'm excited to go back to sports.
Okay. So sports, what do you play, Kaitlin?
Basketball and flag football.
Wow, awesome. All right, you can popcorn it, and you don't have to raise your hand, just to have the conversation, go ahead then.
So I'm excited to go back to school because it's part of our social life too, and we are able to talk to new people and meet new people if they're like changing school.
Gotcha. Yes, ma'am.
I think as a senior, I'm excited to go back to school to see my teachers and friends and things like that. It's my last year, and so I kind of want to make it the most.
Yeah.
But I understand like the issues that there are that we're in right now, and so concerns from teachers and parents. And
so let's build into that. So, you know, there's consensus. Raise your hand if you want to go back to school. Okay, cool. Got a consensus. We're ready to go, ready to transition, charged to get into the classrooms. But let's really piggyback on the start of this conversation about, are there concerns? Do you have concerns as students? Yes, ma'am.
I know that you guys are, cleaning a lot and, making sure that everything's clean and stuff. But like in middle school, there's only like a 4-minute period between each class, and like how are we gonna like make sure that everything's clean in between classes?
Every classroom will have a sanitation station. That means that you will have gloves, wipes, Lysol wipes. You'll have hand sanitizer. You'll have mask. You'll be able to go to that station and get whatever you believe you need in order to protect yourself. As relates to transitions in middle school, we know when the bell rings, it's crazy, right? It's like chaos, and no matter, high school as well, we're gonna have to change that structure, whether we have structured movement, whether we were able to take class A when we escort them to class B, we're gonna have one directional hallways, we'll have staggered release of classes from one class to another. We're definitely gonna have everyone walk, and there'll be arrows on the floor where you have to walk on the right side of the hallway, with a barrier in the middle, so it's gonna look a little different.
So I guess what bothers me the most is that like the sports section of it, cause like I'm a basketball player, yeah. And what keeps me up is that like since I'm going into sixth grade and I trained really hard to make the basketball team, will everything just be canceled? Because since I'm an e-learner, but like if I don't know how to explain it. Like, if I'm an e-learner, will the people that go to school have a bigger chance than me, or e-learners just cannot try out?
Yeah, so we want to respect all the time and energy that you put into to becoming skilled at your athletics or your craft or basketball. You know, when you get a chance, I'll find out when you come over there, and we'll get a little one-on-one action, and we'll see. But overall, you're going to have the same experience. If you go to e-learning, you're going to be able to participate in extracurricular activities and athletics. We want you to have that experience. Yes, sir.
I'm concerned if people are like not gonna care about coronavirus, they're like not gonna wear masks on purpose, and they might get people sick.
Yeah, so that's a legitimate concern. And I mean, we're going to be all over that. You know, the first time we're gonna give everyone 3 reusable masks. Those masks can be, there are a couple of days you can use them. We'll make sure you continue. We'll teach you and coach you how to wash them. And then if you don't have them, we're going to have disposable masks that we'll give you along the way on our campuses. You can have some really cool face coverings, just as long as it's not disruptive, right? As long as it's just not disruptive in the classroom, we want you to be creative with the process. But back to your point is that it's not an option. You know, we're going to require them for a reason. Today, we all have masks. I walk in here and when you transition to the classroom and you don't have one, here's your disposable mask. When you transition and you decide you don't want to wear it, well, here's your disposable mask. And if you're not going to wear it, we're going to call your parents. And if it doesn't happen, then we're going to have them come get the learner.
For like other extracurricular activities, things like football games or just social extracurricular things, how are they going to enforce people to wear masks like all the time? Like it's probably going to be easy like in the classroom or easy enough, but for things like outside of the classroom.
Yeah, so, I mean, where you can social distance, it'll be an opportunity for you to remove a face covering. But we want to make certain that, you know, we're in the process of defining what extracurricular activities look like. Since yesterday we just were informed about the move forward with extracurricular activities. We've got to look at a lot of things with football games. You know, what's the capacity and what can we do to make sure that we look at every one of our facilities to have social distancing within that particular arena? Yes, sir.
All right, so similar to extracurricular activities, what would be the procedures for like festivities like homecoming, eighth grade dance, fifth grade banquet?
Yeah, all of those events openly are going to look different. So we're not going to be able to have massive gatherings. So there's going to be, you know, no different, and I know it was very unpopular related to what happened in the 4th and 9th weeks for seniors. I mean, they didn't even have a traditional ceremony. You name it, they didn't get a chance to experience prom. So, you know, right now, major gatherings are not going to be an opportunity, Curtis. And I know that's not fun, but we can see as we push, you know, we could be pushing Vince back later towards the end of the fall. That may give us a better opportunity to see a downward, a downward trajectory of COVID cases. We may be in a so much better spot that we're able to get and have more openings. But right now, anything that's, you know, over 50 individuals in one point in time and with a gathering that cannot social distance, we just cannot have.
I have a question about lunch.
Okay.
So for lunch, you obviously have to eat, eat through a mask.
So, but, you know, openly, very difficult to do. And as you know, that lunch is always packed up. We're going to have to potentially change hours of lunch. We're going to everything that you know, you usually pick out your lunch and they put on your tray. Everything's going to be pre-designed, pre-wrapped, and you're just going to point, we're going to give to you. No longer are you going to have to go on the keypad and put your student number in. All going to be touchless. You tell us, we'll put it in for you. We'll have barriers for the individuals that are between you and the employees. But as it relates to structure, we're going to have to maximize every large space that we have. What do you think would be some of the toughest, you know, some of the toughest challenges to be able to social distance within our schools? Go ahead.
Well, for me, I still have recess, so okay. How would we be able to do that?
Yeah, I mean, recess, you're outside, right? So you'll have a lot better opportunity to create space outside. So we're going to train coaches. We're going to train all of your specials to make certain that they are taking proactive steps and creating the necessary space so that you can let your hair down. You want to be out. You know, we need recess, right? That's the time for us to go out and relax and get out there and to run off some steam, but that definitely will be implemented along the way. Yes, Ms. Samantha.
I know that not a lot of classrooms are large enough for certain students, and I know that there's not going to be all of our students in the classrooms, but I don't think that there's going to be enough room for us to stay 6 feet apart in each classroom.
Right, hence the reason we're going to have face coverings, but we're going to be very, I mean, this is why, you know, the pushing back school is going to allow us to work with teachers and to look at and rebuild the overall structure of the class. So if we have to move a table in the back that's just, you know, holding a sign, or we're going to have to move, you know, some particular, whether it's file cabinets along the way, to move those particularly out of the classroom for potential pause and create more rooms. Yes, ma'am.
So with e-learning, there is like FLVS, which is, I think, like from a really low age to all the way up to high school.
Right, Florida Virtual.
So would the option of switching all the way to virtual instead of like e-learning per se be an option, or?
It is, but we want you to take Hillsborough Virtual. We have Hillsborough Virtual. We have, you know, make sure we've expanded the number of course offerings that we have, and we have a number of teachers that are excited about that opportunity.
But Hillsborough Virtual and e-learning are both different things, right?
Because they are very different. So e-learning is where you are connected with your school. So if you're at Rampello with Mr. Yeomans, and this is where you attend school, you will have the teachers that are connected to Rampello will be the teachers of record that are educating you, and you will have to follow a rigid schedule as if you were in school. So, you know, first period, second period, third period, or, you know, science, literacy, science block, you have to follow that schedule and check in. From Hillsborough Virtual School, it's self-paced. There'll be targets along the way that you'll have to embed and you'll have to push through, but it's on your pace of when you do your work.
So I'm going to, like, represent an IB program.
Yep.
So I was wondering, we have, like, certain requirements, like IAs, internal assessments, that have to be done, like, in person.
Right.
So for those who are doing e-learning, would you have to, like, resort to, like, Saturdays maybe coming in like perform psychology.
So we are working to have scheduled assessments, and we know that there's going to be assessments, because there'll be state assessments, there'll be baselines, so there's a potential that you'll have to come in and take, we'll get a safe location to take your assessments, and you'll be able to leave school. We're also looking at different software, WebEx software, to zoom in and to watch, have a proctor watch you take your assessment, so we make sure there's purity in it.
So if we were to have a lockdown, would we stay 6 feet apart, or would we still get close together?
So when you have emergencies, and you know, we gotta get out of the building, right? So when we get to a part when we have protocols and procedures that's an emergency and safety issue, we've got to follow the emergency guideline process. So,
how would like teachers be affected if they were to contract COVID? Because my dad's a teacher and
Yeah. So we have protocols in place that we will identify anyone that has symptoms. We will get them linked up with our nurse to determine whether or not they need to be connected with a Department of Health, or they need to be connected with their provider, and take the necessary actions for that educator to be assessed. If it comes back that we have an educator or a student, let's put it on a student that is positive, then we got to have a contact tracing. So we're going to start connecting the dots of every educator or the student that may potentially be positive, who they've come in contact with. And then we'll trace that all the way through the building, and then we'll immediately contact every one of the parents that could potentially be exposed. And then we got to ask multiple questions related to the health department. Have they been around that individual for 15 minutes? Did they have a face covering, and were they social distancing? And that will determine whether or not the clock starts for a 10-day quarantine for students and for the educator.
Going off of like with sports, where obviously there's contact sports, yeah. So like there's football and there's basketball. Would we be having to wear our masks during those activities, or would we be able to take them off for?
So the Florida High School Association just provided guidelines. We're in the process of reviewing those guidelines, and we're going to follow their expectations. And when we're outside of physical activity, we're going to have to determine what would be best practices related to that. And that's going to be us connecting with the Department of Health and other medical experts to determine what the recommendations will be. All right, so anyone choosing to go e-learning? All right, so tell me about, why did you choose e-learning over the classroom?
I mean, I guess e-learning instead of the classroom, it's more because COVID it has been going pretty strong. Like,
right.
Everybody's saying that there's going to be a second wave of COVID. And like, and I don't want to be like in school when that happens. And I like maybe like later I might go to school because the COVID situation has probably like been maybe has reduced and like.
Okay, fair enough. Well, what steps do you think we can take, superintendent, schools, principal, leadership, teachers? What do you think would help remove any type of angst as we return, as you potentially return to school? Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so like when you do the virtual meet the teacher or like at the beginning of the school year, just making sure that you tell the students and the parents like what you're gonna be doing, how you're gonna be doing it, how often, because I know that's like important to me.
Sure.
How often you're gonna be cleaning, like how many kids you're gonna be having.
Yep. Fair. Yes.
Given the circumstances, just try to normalize like going back to school and like having everything try to get back to as normal as possible as we can while still being like safe, because I know a lot of people are scared that like things are going to be super different and they don't know how it's going to be. So like making it as normal as possible post COVID
sure.
as it is now.
You know, best practices, you know, that we everything that we knew that was best practice, that's kind of sitting on the sideline for us, and we've got to redevelop what those new practices will be. Yes, sir.
So I was just going to say to like relieve some anxiety from parents and like families, maybe make them feel more involved. So ask for donations like hand sanitizer, masks, anything that they have extra that maybe their child's school needs.
Yes, sir.
I think if you just give like explicit directions to everybody and just make it really clear, I feel like then more people would follow it than if you just tried to give simple directions. I feel like if you just make it more detailed, even if it's harder to follow, if you just give them exact things to do, then more people are going to follow.
Feel comfortable.
Teachers themselves, we need to make sure that they are zero tolerance, because I know that some teachers are more lenient than others, and they're not going to be a zero tolerance.
Yeah, so it's all about consistency, right? You need to help and coach and support every educator, every learner along the way, so that we can create systems and processes that are more explicit, so that we do have rules and regulations that we're implementing and following. All right, I just want to thank each of you for today and your time. I know you got so many different things you want to be doing on your summer day than hanging out with the superintendent of schools, but really good interaction. I thank you for your thoughtfulness. I thank you for your insight. And know that we're going to get better along the way. And when you see stuff, email me. I'm on the website. And if they don't go to the website, go to the website, and find my email. And I will respond, maybe a crazy hour, but I will respond to you. And we have to get better together, right? So your voice matters. So, don't allow your voice to stop here. Make sure there's accountability with your peers. Make sure there's accountability in having conversations when you see things with your school-based leaders and some of your teachers and your support professionals. They're all there to wrap their arms around you to help you be successful, but we got to make certain we do it together, okay? Have a cool rest of the summer, and look forward to seeing you soon, all right?
Me too.
See you. Have a good day. Thank you.